All right. Give it a minute. Assuming it was just maintenance with my ISP that was causing it. Seems to be all better now. Everything seems to be better. So let's continue where we left off. I saved right when I noticed that the frames are tanking. I did, however, forget to hook this back up. Alright, there we go. So, thank you, game, for having the ability to save anywhere. So we got one more piece of armor to get. We have to go up here. I've been waiting for you. We have to wait for the final boss to show himself, and then go back, and that'll trigger the boss that dropped the last piece of the armor. And then we have to make our way all the way back through the Forbidden Lands again to come back to this point to fight the final boss. And that's the game. My name is Odio, King of Demons. Escape. From my world. We do that wrong. It's supposed to be a boss. I fucked up. But we saved right before. Yeah, you have to wander around a bunch for him to find you, not just leave. You have to actually inspect the statue, not just run up to it. Lost child from another dimension. I fling you into the world of death. Head plucker. Has got a hell of a high defense, that's for sure. I think I can just keep spamming the same stuff. Man, that doesn't do crap. That does a decent amount, though. And he's dead. Yeah. Now we just need to make our way through the Forbidden Land again and beat the final boss. Shouldn't take too long. Counter rate, come on. At least we know we can always run away, but still. It's ridiculous. Finish this. So you have to give his little speech again. Already heard it, buddy. We already heard this, remember? We heard it, we turned around, we left, we fought your little dude. Now we're back. Welcome. Called each of you here to ask you some very, very important questions. Heroes each of you may be, what has the rest of humanity done for you? All anyone's ever done is ask for your help. Distance themselves from harm and rely on others to save them. Are such people even deserving of help in the first place? That is my first question. My second question, for each of you individually. Why? What is the reason for your fight? Why do you continue? Ironclad law of the shinobi? I trust only in my own way. Very well. have all been victorious in your self-important battles. Self-important and indeed selfish. It's right to hurt others to achieve your own ends, no matter how important. You are all the same. Same as the maggots that lived in this realm. Just like them. Say goodbye to this sinful life of pain and woe. It would be funny if all of this game, everything that happened, was just so that he could have an interview with us. And just ended there. It's like, I have questions for you. They will be in my new magazine. He's lost an eye. Now he's a pirate. Yar. Everybody else has had two turns, and Masaru's level 16 attack still hasn't gone off yet. There we go! Definitely not worth it. But at least I got to see it. It is slow as fuck, though. It did 228. Okay, so it is stronger than Suda, and it hits, you know, a big area, but too slow. I should probably start moving everybody towards Cube so they can get healing. I don't know how much HP this dude has. Does that even hit him? I might have to move him. That misses. Get a better formation going. This will work at least until he messes it up by pushing us away. Really got it out for a Boro. Motherfucker. God damn it. Just killed Masuda. Like, what is with the damage ranges in this game? Like, nothing does consistent damage. It's either nothing or half your life. And the attack that was doing like 300 before is now doing less than 100. Like, start this fight over again. I don't get the damage values. They don't make any sense. Alright, so it's just... Probably gonna have to focus on just nerfing the crap out of him for... a few turns. Seriously? It's not the time to be missing. Come the fuck on! What the fuck am I supposed to do when everything misses? Anytime any one of my characters does anything, he destroys someone. Where's the debuff? Can any of my moves work in this fight? See, now we're back to the shit that was making me want to quit this game like 2 and 3 chapters in. Just fucking nothing works. The computer just dodges everything. Definitely not a problem with levels, because I am way over leveled for this. Why does that do so much goddamn damage? Fuck. Why is he has got massive defense. Why is he taking so much goddamn damage? Are all of this guy's attacks just percentage of your health? If so, that's fucking cheap. I don't know why I even bothered bringing a healer character in this. It's completely spread out, and his heals don't match up at all to damage this thing is doing. This does. Pathetic. That's because I've been debuffing the shit out of it this whole time. He's down. And now they're just fucking missing again. Thank you. That's great. Just everybody miss your attack, because every time you do something, it gets a turn. So just make sure that your turn does nothing so it can murder us again. Such amazingly designed difficulty. Like having these two together is the only way to get it to attack them with that, which I don't know why, but for some reason they seem to have better defense against it, whereas the two on the left get murdered. I have no clue why these guys take such little damage from it, and the guys on the left take massive amounts. No... Like, none of their stats are that different. One, I can't tell you how or why. Nothing about that fight makes any damn sense. You win. Now, finish me. Alright, don't remember which one's a good ending, which one's the bad ending. I was gonna do both endings, but I don't want to do that fight again. That was complete and utter bullshit. So, good ending is not kill. Bad. We're here. It's not over yet.
Even if I am beaten, keep on living. You must know the meaning of Odio.
About to fight all the chapter bosses again.
From ancient times. Till the distant future. In eras of peace. And eras of war. In all places. And all times. The impetus of all conflict. Eternal sentiment that will not die so long as there are humans to perpetuate it. It is hatred. It is Odio. I will walk my own path. If you try to stop me, I'll kill you.
Yeah, it looks like we're gonna have to fight all the chapter bosses again. These are all going to be one-on-ones. Because there's a couple of characters that I did not level up at all from what they were when they finished their chapter. Like, honestly, this I feel is just padding. I've seen all this before. And considering we did the evil ending first, this is the third time we see all these scenes. Although, at least the fights that I had the most trouble with, the most bullshit ones, I leveled those characters. Like, this was a bullshit fight that took a bunch of tries. Leveled the shit out of him, so that was easy. Babylon Kick was the one that did the most damage. Pogo didn't really level much from when I fought this. Then again, this boss was easy at the level that I ended at. Although I did have party members. Actually, the one I'm kind of worried about is Sundown. He didn't gain any levels. Does have better equipment though. This should be simple. That was another bullshit fight. Practically RNG. Not even practically, it was. That's right, don't be on diagonal with him, because Gatling gun is bullshit. Molotov is nothing. This was an extremely bullshit fight when I did it on his chapter. I was level 9 then, now I'm like 23.
Why can't I win? Isn't this my destiny? What's the difference between you and I? I would kill anyone blindly so long as the order was given. Then I realize that killing people for the wrong reason is unacceptable. The world cannot be changed by force. Such ideas only lead to more death and sadness. Yoma Sakamoto taught me that the only way we'll be able to change the world is we can place our trust in each other. The world can't be changed by force. Trust people. I think someone told me something like that long ago. When I die, you will all be able to return to your own worlds. Don't forget, anyone can become a king of demons, as long as hatred still exists in any world, at any time. Anyone can become a king of demons. Literally the same thing he just said. I heard you twice the first time. I will preserve Master's teachings. I'm happy enough. At least I have a place to go home to. In retrospect, I probably should have used Akira as a healer instead of Cube. In that last fight, Cube, his healing wasn't really able to do anything. I hit an area, but it was too low. I'll continue my quest to be the strongest. So, life goes on. I have faith. Dawn will always break through the dark of night. Yeah, and the main reason that Cube's heal was useless in that fight is that every time you take an action, the boss gets another action. So Cube's heal would only be worth it if it healed for at least double what the boss was doing, which it didn't. So I had no choice but to pass his turn. Healing people actually either negated itself, or he caused, or was detrimental, depending on how much damage the attack that it triggered would do. Which, when I finally, I guess, manipulated his AI into attacking the Disciple and Cube, that was actually the case, because he was only doing like 50 points of damage and Cube would heal for like 120. Which, I can only assume his damage was based off your IQ stat, maybe. No, because Oboro had a high IQ stat. Like, Cube and the Disciple were both max. They were like 99 plus 99, and they were taking like 50 damage. Oboro, he wasn't max, but he was really high. He was still taking a whole bunch of damage from it.
Masaru had, like, no IQ, and he was getting destroyed by it. So maybe that's what it is, but... Like, even Oboro had to have had at least 150 total. And he was still taking, like, 250 damage from those attacks, which was half his life. That's ridiculous. Especially... Like, cubes was... I don't know what the formula for cubes healing is, but... He was only getting 120 off of that heal that hits the area around him. Obviously not based off of IQ, because that was... Unless maybe it was based off of power? I never bothered to check that to up his power and see if it healed more. I don't know, but all the numbers behind this game don't make a lot of sense. I'd actually see some, like, the mechanics to figure out how to build things. I don't know. It's almost like a Saga game in that respect. The mechanics are very obtuse, but. Unlike Saga games, nobody's really dived through to explain them on this. Hell, even Unlimited Saga, which everybody claims to hate, has super in-depth mechanics guides so you can know how every little detail works. It's a good concept. There's been a couple of games that have done a similar thing before with, like, the... multiple protagonists that all meet up in the end. Not necessarily like this, where they're all different time periods. I can't think of any that did that. The story could be really good, but it wasn't told well here. I think that's more because of the age. Like, there wasn't a lot of room to really flesh out stories in Super Nintendo games. Like, this game could be remade and heavily expanded on. It could probably be something great, because they'd need to flesh out the story. It's basically the idea, the setting, and the building blocks of it that are really good. Everything else kind of needs to be scrapped if they try to remake it. But it does... It probably could really use one. Like, definitely look under the hood at the numbers and try to make them make more sense. Like, I still don't even know if any of those stats affect the charge time of charged spells. So is this just introducing my team first? I saw that move a grand total of one time because the charge for it is so ridiculously long. I guess it's just showing the highest level skill that you got on them, because... Yeah, on Pogo and him, I didn't get their best. Nor on him, either. Although, as I said, the way that last battle played out, I probably would have been better off with Akira instead of Cube. Is the end of Live Alive. Squaresoft. As I said, a good premise, good idea, but you know, Super Nintendo level storytelling, which it's not the best I've ever seen on Super Nintendo, but it's not the worst either. It's probably somewhere in the middle. Could be done a lot better if something like this were to be done nowadays. But it is a very good premise. It was a good idea. The battle system was kind of all over the place. Every fight was either, as far as difficulty, every fight was either a 1 or an 11. Like, it was either you had no chance of losing, or you had to pray for RNG to win. Which, again, happened a lot in those days. So this probably would have been a really good game back then. Like, obviously a lot of it frustrated me because I'm not 12 anymore. I don't have, like, well, 1994, so figure 2 years to be translated. Were it translated in 1996, I would have been 15, 16 at the time. Yeah, I mean, teenager, you don't really have much else to do but sit there and pore over every detail of a game. At least that's the way it was back then. Like, my first JRPG was Phantasy Star 3, and that one is just as cryptic and just as bullshit as this one was, and I sat there and figured out every little detail of it. Same with Dark Wizard, that's a strategy RPG that I had on Sega CD at the time. And there's so much little hidden details and other things you have to do to try to get the best ending, and I sat there and figured them all out through trial and error. Obviously, I don't have the patience for figuring things out through trial and error now, which is why I would look at a guide when something was cryptic. But honestly, Square would do good to remake this and flesh out the story more and update the battle system. If nothing else, make the numbers make more sense. Because if they just re-released it like this, it probably is going to piss a lot of people off, because it did frustrate the hell out of me at certain times. Like, this is definitely not a Chrono Trigger that can stand the test of time and still be fun today. But I think it would have been good and fairly well received back then had they decided to bring it out. I don't know why they didn't. But anyway, that's Live Alive. It's my final thoughts on it. No stream tomorrow, because tomorrow is my day off, and then when we start back up on Sunday night, Monday morning, we'll be starting Yakuza 3 Remastered, which is the black sheep of the family for the Yakuza series, from what I understand. But that one we're playing, like, I'm mostly hooked on the story for Yakuza, so depending on how bad the combat is, what its reputation is, how fast we rush through it. So, that's another game down. Returning to the Yakuza series next time with 3 Remastered. Thank you all for watching, and until then, I'm just going to go ahead and end early here, because I've got Castlevania Season 3 to watch, and it's really good, and I want to get back to it. So, see you later.